So, hello, welcome back to another video. I am kind of repeating one from yesterday because some people said it was really dark to see, and also because I wanted to add some pictures of how it looks in real life, because I think on the video it's sometimes difficult to see how the tape, the gun tape that we are using, so the tape for on the grips, how it actually looks. So I sent somebody else some pictures, and he was like, well, this looks a lot better than I expected. And yeah, I am now going to order. So I figured let's make a new one. So we'll start off showing you some pictures that I sent to somebody, how it really looks out in the real world, and not maybe because I've not set up the studio or whatever you want to call this correctly. But I wanted to show you some pictures that you can see it. So now my iPad, and you can see this is now kind of the front sort of area. I already for some other Facebook groups took some multiple pictures. I will just walk through them. Some of them are dubs, and then we will go back to the real setup. But here you can see only, of course, the tape is a little bit in the lower part. You can see how the side now looks. Right, another one from the side, the difference, well, I don't think there is a difference. So this is how when the Peak Design strap is basically taken out. And again, you can see that in reality it looks pretty close to the material from Sony. It's not perfect, but it's probably better than when I was showing it on the video. So here you can also see me using the handle, right, which has very little to do with the gun tape, although that's also filled with the same gun tape, which you'll clearly see on this side. So it's really fun stuff. So some possible setups, but of course it was more about the gun tape, so let's go back to that again. And this will be a much shorter video than yesterday. So if you want to see more about it, yeah, look at the one from yesterday. So first let's go to this picture. So now put it on a green sort of thing. I put an average lens on there, or at least a very popular one, just to kind of show you how difficult it actually is to see that you have the grip on and how it then looks, right? So from both sides, I think it looks even now, maybe because I white balance the cameras, it looks already a lot better. And again, the perfect, there's no lighting I have not set up in this space. We'll turn it around, and then I will take the lens off, and you can see better what is going on. But I figured it was good to also put like a lens that a lot of people are using, or similar size lenses on there, to show you what's up, right? So again, the grip, how you can now hold it and how it will look. I hope that's that makes sense. So let me so maybe also do one top shot, although that will be much more difficult to see. I'm guessing near impossible. Well, we can like take the hood off, but you can kind of see how it will look from this side, right? It looks quite integrated into the rest of the mount now, of the grip, sorry. So let me take the lens off and put a cap on there, so that we can have a better look. Okay, and let's go back to this view again. And well, let me put the lens away for a second. And you can clearly see now that how it was, how it looks when it's integrated. So let me go from to the top camera. And I think it looks quite nice in color now also, right? So it's much more clear. So what I did, let me repeat a little bit from yesterday. I basically put some of the gun tape material over here, and then only on the part, on the basically the door part. So you can see it on this side and on this side. And the automatic result, if you look at it from this angle, is that it feels much more solid. And that's the only way I can say it. There's less movement already, although I've also adapted another trick, but it feels more more connected to the rest of the camera, simply because you don't have this metal feeling anymore. You now feel the tape, which you're also feeling when you're touching the rest of the body. I hope this makes sense. And the same is true if you look from the top view for this part, because your hand is over here, it kind of feels the same, same warmth, especially if you are walking outside with it. So that works very well. The second thing I showed yesterday already, but I'm going to repeat now a bit. So let me see how that is a good way to show you. Probably from this camera, and I will zoom in a little bit. So give me a sec. I'm pretty sure I'm going to put that camera on the other side. It makes it easier for me. Like I said, this is a very temporary setup. But you can see that the Peak Design plug, now I've put it in here. And it's quite easy to take out, hopefully. Although I didn't do it since yesterday. But there it goes. You can see the plug coming out. Sorry, I hit my microphone. And then of course you can use some of the straps like this one. If you're not into Peak Design, I know a lot of you are. As you can see now, your safety strap is on. And you can put it on your arm. I always tighten it up a little bit. Just feels more comfortable. And here we go. We are fully locked in. You can see, because the hole is quite big, that it's quite easy now not to be bothered by it. I hope this makes sense. Because, well, it sort of goes to the side into the hole area. So I think most of the problems that people are having with the grip part feeling sharp. Oh, I'm on the wrong lens, sorry. So most people which figured that this felt very sharp, that effect is now gone. So let me also show you the bigger sort of Peak Design strap. Oops. Now mine is a little bit adapted, because what I do, let me first show that, which I guess also fits with this sort of story. I put a safety wire between my Peak Design strap. The reason why I did this is because not only because if one of the plugs breaks, which I doubt, or even on the small rig design, one of the connections somehow breaks. I think the chances are not zero, but very small. I think it was more likely that I detach one side, then forget about it and let go. And then, of course, the way that this strap works, my camera will drop to the floor, which you don't want. So what I did, I put a safety wire in between. I think I have to make a little bit of a longer wire, or I need to start putting some tape on these parts. I might actually do that, some gun tape. Simply because I'm a little bit afraid it can scratch your screen if you're not careful. But let's plug this one in. So again, I've put the mine on the side. So now the one's over here. And of course, there's no lens on there now. Although I could do that, I guess. But you can see that it will then automatically work fine if you're taking pictures. Let's see from top view. This doesn't really block your view. I'm a little bit afraid that at some point, although it's difficult, it could reach my screen. Not sure about that. We'll figure it out. But you can see this is working fine also. And I think this is no problems there. So let me take it off again and then open it up and show you what we've done there. And maybe also show you some other small tricks I'm going to still do. So when you saw my original review, hopefully, I was still a bit complaining about the possible movement of this grip, right? So let me go to the other angle. So a little bit about this grip. One of the downsides of the new design is that the door can now open so that this is now totally smooth, right? So this area, it now is much more better than the 2122, but you could theoretically feel some movement in the door. And the tape the gun tape also kind of already helped a little bit with that, because when we are opening it up, you'll see that, and this is still a prototype, not of the small rig part, that's in production version. They just sent me a copy, pre-made copy, so pre-production copy, and the only mistake that's in there is basically a little marker that they forgot to put on here. So for the rest, it is not going to change. So let me open it up. And you know, there's a button here now. If you've seen the previous video, you can open it up like that. And you can see that if I'm going to figure out how to put this, I guess best way is to do it like this. Put it on the back and then go to this one. You can see that there's two things that I've done. The first thing is I've put, you can see that the tape is already totally around this. And I already put a, let's call it a prototype plugin there, which for me will do two things. The first thing is it will create a room for my peak design to basically go inside and hide in a nice way that I can still get it in and out in a quick way. The second thing what is going to do for me, and I didn't totally finish that yet, is that I'm going to make a rubber seal basically that together with the bottom of the camera will act as a second seal, right? So the first seal is basically you taping up, let me show that again, you taping up this little flap, which is the weakest point on the whole bottom side of the camera, right? The second thing you should do is tape up a little bit the holes in the back plate. So there's six screws there. I would tape them up if I were you. But the weakest point, well, weakest point is basically the cable feeder over here, which you can tape up there. And also, I see now that mine is removed. I also will put back a little bit of tape over this part again. By mistake, I removed it. But then the plan for me, at least, is to put a weather sealing or a rubber sealing in here. And when I close it up, it will actually create a third totally protective sort of layer, right? And you can see that the magnet is still working and it's still locking up. And if you don't want to watch yesterday's video, because I kind of repeated all the arguments already, you can see that this structure that they made using a magnet and a metal bar in here, which is the mechanism for holding it, is probably already strong enough. I didn't ask, but I'm assuming because there's a steel bar in there, I think it's about, my guess would be between 1.5 and 2 millimeters, is actually also supported by a little bit of a plug that you see here, which goes in, which of course is controlled with this button, but it goes into a hole over here inside the body. Hopefully you can't see, but you have to believe me, there's a hole there. And this also is about 2 millimeters, maybe 3, and it locks into place, right? So that means that if you pull it from here, it actually has 2 places where something needs to go wrong before it might possibly break or whatever. Now, even then, I am pondering to, but let me first take this plug out. I had some trouble getting it out yesterday because it's kind of hacked in there. And with a little bit of bad luck, it will be difficult to get out today again. So I'm doing that off camera. I probably have to get up and get a little tool. Now, the nice thing about small rig, there's tools always hiding in all kinds of weird places. So let me get one from this grip. Yeah, there it is. And take the little rubber prototype thing off. And again, not everybody has to do it. I'm weirder than other people. I kind of don't mind sometimes adapting stuff that I buy to make it perfect for me. Maybe this is just my attitude. I kind of like it, and then I communicate back to the company, and hopefully in the next release they will improve it even further, right? So now you can see how I put in the gun tape. On top of it, I just sort of flapped it over. It's a really easy thing to do. And you can see that the plug is now sort of, if I would not have made the plug, then this would be somewhere in here, which is fine in itself. but it will be difficult to get out sometimes from this side. So I wanted to basically allow it to be hiding like this, so it's easier to get out. So that's why they made this plug. And the second thing is to also make sure that the ceiling I want to make can actually be on top of this, again, prototype plug. So the weather ceiling will be over here. And the magical part on the bottom is this hole where the Peak Design plug will be living. So not sure what else to say about this. In the original plan, I was also, maybe I'll still do this, put some slides in here, or two slits in here, to put two extra flashcards in there if I by mistake forget one. Of course, there's two in the bodies of the Sonys, but if for some reason I needed a backup, I was still pondering to put two flashcards in there, because there's enough room for that. So let me put this plug back. And press it back in. Again, I will make one which is totally fitting. And then you can see I can put this plug back and lock it up again. And there it goes. You see, and now because it can't go anywhere, it will stay in that little space that I created for it. Okay. Yeah, that's about everything I wanted to show you in this video. So let's go to this one again. So the gun tape, I will put a link in the description. Maybe there's better stuff for this. I have not found it. I decided also to contact this company again to see if they're willing to make a really even better fitting one for the Sony cameras, because it could be a little bit darker, a little bit blacker, and also the texture is different. It's close, but not perfect, right? This costs about, I will put a link in the description, about $7 for 3 strips. I personally, I would probably get 6 of them, so 2 packs. And then you can fill around it in multiple things. I already use it in many places, not just on my cameras, and on like the grip that I've showed in the other video, which you can put on the side over here, right? I've put it in multiple places already. So this is the end of the video. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.